Heather, let's talk about a teacher in hot water for, of all things, of all horrible things, horror of horrors, buckle your seatbelts, folks, taking a sick kid to the hospital.
Yep, in Tennessee, Jennifer Mitz was apparently, she claims that she was pressured to resign from her position. She had been a teacher for about 14 years. Apparently, she had taken an ill 20-year-old student to the hospital and then also paid the hospital bill because the student was uninsured.
Right.
But according to the school, it's a much different story. They said that they were intending to suspend her, that she quit on her own, and that she had been reprimanded previously for similar incidents and doing other things wrong. For the school, basically, it's a liability issue. Taking a student off of campus in your car is prohibited.
Right.
The teacher claims that she thought since this student was over the age of 18 that there would be less of a concern or less of a problem.
Yeah.
But then the school officials say the classroom was left unattended, so that's another issue. Basically, they said she was just way out of line.
So many weird things about the story. One is that we're talking about a 20-year-old student.
Right.
I don't know. I guess I'm old-fashioned. When I was in school, nobody was 20 in my high school. Anyway, and then secondly, yes, they said they had all these other incidents. They claimed the district apparently wanted to get rid of this teacher before this, or had at least disciplined her for other kinds of infractions.
She had been previously disciplined, but I mean, people in the school community are supporting the teacher. There's a petition that has 500 signatures in support of her. So I think a lot of people are viewing it as she's a kind-hearted person who was going above and beyond to help her students. But I think that the school does make some very interesting points about liability and leaving the classroom unattended.
And just to be skeptical about her for a second, too, this, when people say they're forced to resign, I mean, it's one thing if you're forced to sign something because, like, you're in North Korea and Kim Jong-un is holding you or something like that, but forced to resign, and then you go to the press saying, but they're mean because they made me resign and I didn't want to, and they forced... What level of force was used in this scenario is what I would likely wonder. But I don't know. Ben, you have a wrap on this one?
It always comes down to liability, doesn't it? I mean, you just can't... A teacher cannot be a human being. Assuming her story, again, you know, this is all freighted with caveats, right?
Right, right.
Assuming her story is on the up and up, you cannot be a human being at a school or really anywhere because of liability issues. And I don't know what it's going to take, but it is strange that the detail about the student being 20 struck me as being particularly odd. Maybe if you have 19 and 20-year-old students, you can have a waiver. Everybody just needs to sign a waiver. Liability waivers for everybody. If that's the way we get to be, human beings. I mean, remember the story? There was the story. I think you might have covered it 2 or 3 weeks ago about there was a fire alarm. I think it was in Idaho. And these two students were on the swim team, and they were taken outside, and they couldn't go back in.
No, we did, we did. Yeah. The girl was made to stand outside in a bathing suit, and it was either freezing or at least like 40 degrees or cold. Heather, did you do that story? It was very cold outside, and she actually got frostbite standing outside because the rule was you can't go back in the building. Because the fire alarm is going. First of all, she's in the pool. The odds are she's not going to burn to death in the pool, if you ask me. Right. She's safer staying there. But anyway,
That wasn't the thing. The thing was, I mean, yes, you couldn't go back in the school, but the thing was she wasn't allowed to sit in a teacher's car.
Right. That's right. They finally did it anyway. Some sort of civil disobedient decided to put her in the car anyway, but it took a long... She had to get frostbite first, essentially.
That's right.
Yeah.
It's madness. I mean, that sort of thing is just... It's madness, and it's part of this... Not just this whole, crazy fear of lawsuit culture, but also this kind of zero tolerance culture has emerged in public schools over the past 20 years, where there can be no discretion, there can be no good judgment... it just has to be, there has to be a policy and a protocol for everything.
Yeah.
And if you deviate from it, you're out.